Hello children, today we're going to discuss the chapter 7, Glimpses of India, and we're going to discuss the summary of this chapter's part 2, and the name of this part is Coorg, and it is written by Lokesh Abrol. He is a consultant of internal medicine and a social entrepreneur. He is also the founder director of Arvindam Foundation and Esther. In this lesson, the narrator has given a vivid description of Coorg, a heavenly place which lies between Mysore and Mangalore. It is the smallest district of Karnataka. It has evergreen forest, spices and coffee plantation. Many visitors come to it between September and March. The weather is fine then. The air is full of coffee flavor. The people of Coorg belonged to Greek or Arabic descent. There is a story behind it. When a part of Alexander's army moved towards south coast and settled there, they could not return to their native place. These people married amongst the locals. Their culture is reflected in the martial traditions, marriages and religious rites. The Arab origin is seen in the long black coat worn by Khudavis. It is known as Kopia. It is like kufia worn by the Arabs and the Kurds. Coorgi people are famous for their tradition of hospitality. A number of tales of bravery are related to their sons and fathers. In the Indian Army, the Coorg regiment is very famous. General Kariappa, the first chief of the Indian Army, was also a Coorgi. In our country, only Khudavis are permitted to carry firearms without a license. The river Kaveri gets its water from Coorg's forest and hills. Mahaseer, the largest freshwater fish, is found in these waters. Kingfishers, squirrels and langurs are found near these waters. Birds, bees and butterflies give one a good company here. Elephants enjoy being bathed here by their mahouts. River rafting, rappelling, rock climbing and mountain biking are the main activities of the Coorg area. The Brahmagiri hills give the climber a whole view of Coorg. A walk across the rope bridge leads to the 64-acre island of Nisargadhama. Tibetan settlement live in Bailakupe here. One can see them dressed in red and yellow robes. So this was the story about Coorg. Now I hope you understood the chapter very well. When you look at the questions of this chapter, it will be easy for you to answer them.